What if I tell you that we were, we are, and if we do not change our ways in the foreseeable future, we will also be learning programming in the wrong way? Yes, today we are learning programming in the wrong way. Sounds far-fetched, right? It will not after you listen to me. You know, have you ever wondered why it happens that a programmer who is learning programming via some tutorial or via some college and schools or as a self-paced learning, the difference between the skill set they have and the difference between somebody who has practical experience, why there is a huge gap between these two? Of course, practical experience does matter in all the places, all the industries, all the work, but the difference between people having no practical experience and people having practical experience in programming is huge, okay? And for the programmers who have learned programming, when they go to a production system, everything looks new to them. Why? Why this is the case? I know why. So whenever anyone learns a programming language, irrespective of the programming language you are learning, irrespective of the way you are learning, you have to understand that each and every program consists of only two things. Only two things. These two things are data and functions which acts on that data. Now, the problem is that while learning programming in the last 4-5 decades till today, we used to focus on functions, understanding, creating and writing functions. We never focused on data. Yes, you heard me right. We focused on functions. We never focused on data because all of us learned programming with a misconception that I need to be able to write the function. I need to understand, you know, overloading of functions and so on and so forth, without realizing that the crux of any program we write in this world, the intention of that program is to manipulate, use, store, and access data. It's all about data. It's not about functions. This is the difference nobody understands. That's why people learn complete programming language with, you know, few variables, few classes. During their learning journey, they never access, use, create, or manipulate large amount of data. And when they move to a production system, it is all about large amount of data. The problem is that if you just create one producer consumer, you know, code, that doesn't mean you have understood multi-threaded programming. That's not only a misconception, it's stupid, right? Producer consumer problem is not teaching you multi-threaded, okay? It just gives you the very basic idea of what the problem will be like. It doesn't teach you. To actually understand multi-threaded programming, you need to make sure that you have large amount of data roaming around large amount of threads, and you are managing that, you are controlling that, you are making sure that the access is sacrosanct to that particular data which should be accessed by only one entity or one thread. That's how you learn multi-threaded programming. Similarly, when people learn programming, I don't know how far it is true, but based on my own experience, I can say that people end up their programming learning activity by limiting themselves to 2, 3, 4, 5 files at max. But when they go to production system, wow, hundreds of files for a particular project. They don't know how the data is being flowing around all those places, okay? So just by creating few files and transferring data from one function to another, that is not the crux of the program. Remember, we write code to solve complex problems, not the simple problems. We learn programming just with a simple set of problems. We never ever touch a complex issues, complex problems, and problems involving large amount of data. Data is everything. Concentrate on data while learning anything. Concentrate on data while learning programming. Concentrate on data while learning database. Concentrate on data while learning, you know, machine learning. Concentrate on data while learning anything in this software development ecosystem. With this, I do hope and believe that I made my case. Thank you all. Thanks for watching. We will meet again. Until the next time we meet, good day, goodbye. You take care.